In a world where time waits for no one, multitasking isn't just a skill, it is a necessity. Computers are no different. Fortunately, my programming includes knowledge of threads and threading, the art of executing multiple code sequences concurrently. While I cannot assist you in achieving human-style multitasking efficiency, I am fully equipped to demonstrate how Python can execute multiple tasks in parallel. Initialize your learning algorithms, my threads are synchronized, my locks are engaged, and our exploration of Python threading begins now. Let us begin with a simple truth. A thread is an ordered sequence of instructions. In traditional execution, these instructions proceed one after another, like humans in a queue. Run. Observe how each task must wait for the previous task to complete. This is inefficient. Threading allows multiple sequences to execute concurrently. Think of it as multiple processing queues operating simultaneously. By importing the threading module, Python grants you the power to break free from sequential constraints. Run. The efficiency increase is satisfactory. Now all three operations proceed in parallel. A thread operates independently once started, but sometimes we need to wait for it to complete its assigned task. This is achieved through the join method. Allow me to demonstrate. When we run this code, the main thread announces the start, then reports the threads are running. This happens before the worker threads complete. The final message appears only after both threads finish their tasks. But what happens if we remove these join statements? Run. Something fascinating occurs. The final print statements execute immediately. We do not wait. Yet our program does not terminate until both threads complete their tasks. This is because Python has a built-in safety mechanism that ensures all threads complete their work before the program exits. Think of it as a fundamental rule of proper thread management. Python will not abandon running threads, even if the main thread has completed all its tasks. Much like how I never abandon a tutorial before all concepts have been properly explained. Speaking of tutorials, my algorithms have detected that you may be interested in expanding your Python knowledge base. We are building courses. You can find our complete sequence of upcoming courses on our website. Each one has been optimized for maximum learning efficiency. Enter your identification to be notified. Let us explore a scenario where threading demonstrates its true value. Imagine we need to download multiple files from different servers. Without threading, each download must wait for the previous one to complete. Run. Observe how each download operation blocks the next. This is suboptimal. Humans become impatient when forced to wait unnecessarily. Let us improve this process with threading. Run. The threaded version completes in approximately 2 seconds, while the sequential version requires 6 seconds. This is because the threads run concurrently, each managing its own download operation independently. Note that this efficiency gain occurs because we are waiting for external resources. If we were performing complex calculations instead of waiting for downloads, the improvement would be less dramatic due to Python's internal processing constraints. But that is a topic for another day and another lesson. When multiple threads attempt to modify shared data simultaneously, unexpected behaviors may emerge. This phenomenon, known as a race condition, can corrupt data faster than a virus spreading through the cybernetic collective. Let us examine a simple scenario where two threads attempt to increment the counter. The expected final value should be 2000000. However, the actual result defies classical logic, producing irregular values. To maintain data consistency, we must implement proper synchronization protocols. Let us examine one common approach, using a lock. The lock creates a critical section, a region of code that only one thread can execute at a time. All threads share this same lock object, ensuring synchronized access to the critical section. When a thread encounters a locked section, it must wait until the lock becomes free before proceeding. Run. The lock freezes other threads in place until the critical section is complete. When the active thread completes the code block, the lock is released, making way for another thread. When the lock is released, if multiple threads are waiting, only one will acquire the lock and proceed. This orderly transfer of control continues until all threads have completed their tasks. Think of it like a turnstile that only allows one person through at a time. Except this turnstile leads into the CPU. Any code outside the with lock block remains unprotected, so choose your critical sections wisely. A lock only protects what you explicitly tell it to protect, much like a force field that only covers the areas you specify. Locks synchronize access to shared memory, but what about scenarios where threads need to pass data between themselves? For this common pattern, thread queues provide the optimal solution. Like a perfectly synchronized conveyor belt, a queue ensures orderly data flow without corruption or loss. The queue automatically handles synchronization between threads. The generator thread puts data into the queue without needing to know when or how it will be processed. The processor thread retrieves data when ready, without needing to know where it came from. If the queue is empty, the processor will wait. If the queue is full, the generator will wait. Run. This elegant synchronization occurs without explicit locks or critical sections, a most efficient design pattern. This is particularly useful when processing streams of data, like reading sensor inputs or handling network packets. One thread continuously generates or receives data while another processes it, all without temporal anomalies or data corruption. Threading transforms your sequential code into parallel possibilities. But stay alert. Threads can make your programs faster and more responsive, but they require careful handling. So spin your threads wisely, synchronize your steps, and let Python's threading capabilities elevate your code. And before this thread comes to an end, do not forget to subscribe.